Hi all, if you found this video, I hope this applies to you, and I hope that this is helpful to you. I've been using Sony Vegas for since about version 13 or 14, so a little over half a decade. I'm moving to After Effects as of right now, but I wanted to leave my knowledge with Vegas behind to any aspiring COD or FPS editors or anybody of the sorts who want to get into that sort of editing, any newer people that can't find a good tutorial on YouTube, even though there's tons out there, and just want something nice and simple. So I'll try to make this as short as I can. I'm going to go through the absolute basics of COD editing that can apply to other games too, such as like Valorant, CSGO, games like that. And I hope it's helpful. All right, so I've got here a clip from someone that I edited for on the Team Taj. This is a Call of Duty Ghost clip. Now the first thing I'll say is if you're ever editing anything, whether it's your own clips or someone else's or whatever, try to get them in 60 frames. Editing 30 FPS is very difficult when it comes to syncing and certain aspects because it just makes it harder with lower frame rate clips. So to check the frame rate of the clip before you start editing, you can right click, hit properties, and you'll say the FPS right here. If it says 59.94 or 97, that's okay. That's technically still the same frame rate, just a little bit less, but it really won't make much of a difference. So to start, one of the most basic things is syncing. It's the backbone of pretty much any project, any edit you'll ever make. There's no sync, there's no flow. So I'll give a little demonstration of how to sync very quickly. All right, so I've pulled in a song here. It's just a song from Ghost Main, one I've been wanting to use for a little while, and I figured this would be a great way to show how to edit or how to sync to a good song with a lot of beats to it. So obviously the first thing to do is just save it as whatever. And you'll want to go through, turn down, press V to pull up this little volume bar to turn the volume up and down, and just go through and listen to it and mark out beats with M on your keyboard. This is how you mark out certain beats. So I'll just really quickly speed this up and mark the beats on the song. Alright, this is a really, really basic marker tutorial. You've seen I've gone through and marked pretty much every spot where there's a beat in the first about 10 seconds. Now some of these markers you'll see are not actually beats but lyrics, so I'll play this out real quick. So you'll see these three beats right here, or two, are actually synced to lyrics, and that's okay. It's really good to have diversity whenever you're syncing things. You don't always have to sync to the beat. If you can find a good lyric or a part in the song where it's a distinct part where you'll be able to sync a shot or any part of it, definitely do it. Don't limit yourself to just beats. Like here, you see there's two beats right here. These are really, really good to edit to. The more beats, the better. But you don't want to limit yourself to just that. So if you have a song that's very like lyric heavy, not a lot of beats, you can still use that for sure. You just kind of got to find that flow yourself. That's not something that anybody can teach you when it comes to editing anything, whether it's real life or game videos. Flow is all of your own style. Everyone has their own flow. It's okay to like copy or mimic your flow off of someone else's, but ultimately you're going to want to get your own flow. So the next thing you're going to want to do is start syncing. So click on the clip, right click, insert, remove envelope, and hit velocity. This is, at least in Vegas, how it'll work for syncing anything. So you can double click to add a marker. You can raise that up. In my version, 16 up to 1,000. In older version, I think it's like 300. And then what I usually do, a good standard rule of thumb for syncing, is there's two, you can see there's two wavelengths here, one here and one here. On the left one, always set this to slow fade. On the right one, always set this to fast fade. That's just the best way to get the smoothest flow. So I'll real quick go ahead and sync this, and then I'll show you an example of what I'm talking about. So one other thing is there's a good general rule of thumb. It's called the 350-50-300 rule. Not something that a lot of people use, but sometimes I like to use. So it's where you use about three or four different kinds of markers. The first one is at 50% forward velocity. The next one's at 300% forward velocity. 50%, 50, 300, 50, 50, 300. Keeping it consistent is really good. I wouldn't I wouldn't do like 700 here, 300 here, 100 here, you know what I mean? You want to keep it consistent so the flow isn't messed up and doesn't feel unnatural to the viewer. You can see here, I usually start at about a couple milliseconds before the beat is. You start the flow or the build up here. This is where the specific point of the video will be, and then it flows back down to 50%. Now, doing 50% will not work if you've got a 30 FPS clip. It just looks better and you can flow and sync a lot better. Normally, slowing down your clip to 50% and then doing forward velocity up to 300 or 200 and then back down and up and then down and up and then down like you can see here is one of the best ways to achieve this sort of velocity flow. Now this is just a really rough example. You're gonna wanna fine tune a lot more than what I'm doing here. A lot of people, including myself, don't actually do any velocity syncing before the shot hits, and that's totally okay. That's another style of editing that a lot of people do, but I'm gonna go ahead and finish this out so you can see kind of what I'm talking about. I would definitely open up your own software, experiment with this, see what feels the best for you before you make any kind of a decision. Remember that every edit is going to be different. Some edits this might work, some edits it might work differently. Not all clips will flow the same, some have different styles. If you're editing sniping clips too, I would definitely get into that in a different tutorial. People actually want that. But for the majority of this community, a lot of people do trick shots, a lot of people don't actually do sniping, so this might work better for that sort of thing. Alright, the next thing I want to get into is pan and crop. This is another really, really important part of editing. Without it, your edits will not have the same flow as they would with it. So normally the way that you do that is you would split the clips from wherever you want them to be. For mine, again, it all really works off the song. If the song doesn't have a lot of beats, there might not be as much pan and crop. But just for the song that I'm using right now, I would split where each marker I have is. And if you see this little square box thing right here, you click that, it's going to bring up your event pan and crop. And this is how I do it. So I'll come about a few milliseconds past the clip and I will take this and just move it in a little bit. You can see like that. Now sometimes if you don't have these things markered, it's going to be not snapping. So what you want to do is you want to mark lock aspect ratio and size about center, and you'll be able to move it more linear. So I would go a little bit in like this, and at the very end you want to set it back to default. And what this will do is it'll pump the clip in a little bit. You can see here it pumps clip in, then it fades back out. And then if you do that again on the other clips, again, really rough, but this is what it would look like. So this is, you can see after every beat or every marker, it pumps out and then it comes back in, pumps out, comes back in. Combine this with some effects and it starts to look really nice. So that compared to not having it is a pretty big difference already. All right, now we'll do that. So we'll go ahead and put our pan crop in. We have our velocity syncing that we have in. Again, all rough, it's not anything very very fine-tuned, so definitely fine-tune it before you go any further, mess with it a little bit, get the flow that you're looking for, and then we'll go on to effects. Again, this is just really basic, it's not anything crazy. I'm going to show you some basic effects, some plug-in effects, and we'll go from there. So the effects that I use on this software, at least, are Bohr's Continuum Suite, I use the Sapphire Suite, I use the Universe Suite, and I use the Magic Bolt Look Suite. All four of these suites do cost money. Obviously, you can find them online however you please, but those are just the ones that I use. So a few that I love to use, obviously, are Magic Bolt Looks is great for color correction. This gives you almost an entirely full range to do whatever you want. Without it, you kind of have to work between a different couple effects, so it's really nice to just have one central effect that does everything color correction-wise. If we open it up, you can see we've got Post, Camera, Lens, Monte, and Subject. If you come over to Tools, this is where you'll find your hue and saturation. is where you'll find your diffusion, which is great. A lot of people use diffusion. It looks really good. You can mess with it here, get it to the exact look that you want. There's also a lot of presets. I'll put my presets in the description. These are just ready-to-go, ready-made presets that I have found or I have made. I do recommend making your own, though. It's not really all that great to use presets for everything unless you've made them yourself. But they're a good building block to learning how to do your own CC. Now, if you don't have Magic Bullet looks and you're in Vegas, there's a couple of different things you can use. So Vegas has their own color corrector. You can apply it. It's just called color corrector. You can modify the lows, the highs, the mids, saturation, gamma, and a couple other things. There's some presets here, but again, it's not really going to give you the amount of freedom that looks will give you. So I do recommend picking up looks if you can. There's color balance, there's a couple other things you can use. Curves is a good one. This is good for contrast, saturation, tints, and stuff like that. You've got your Gaussian blur. Blur is really good for a lot of different reasons too. It's good for effects, transitions, stuff like that. I can go more in depth on this in a different tutorial, but I just want to point out some of the more basic ones. Another really great one is pretty much any kind of glow. So Sapphire Glow is a really, really great glow. You can use the glow that comes with Vegas. It's really great, but it doesn't give you the same freedom that Sapphire Glow gives you. Now the last one that I'll show you that I like to use a lot, Universe. Almost all of these Universe effects work really well. Glow-Fi is a really great effect that I would get used to. Hollow Matrix looks really good for text in certain transitions. Putting it on basic, it's going to look pretty crazy, but you can keyframe it down and get it ready to go pretty easily. And another one I like to use, if I could find it, RGB separation is a great one. And then there's one more, let me find it, Chromatic Aberration, I hope I said that right, is also a really great one. You can keyframe this and make it look exactly how you want it. But this is a great effect to use as well. And again, I'll go more in depth on effects on a different video if people want to see it. I don't want to go too into it on this video because this is more of just a basics type thing. That's pretty much it for that. The last thing I'll go over is sound effects because they are important. So you can find sound effects pretty much anywhere online for any gun. This gun is called the Lynx, so I'm going to go ahead and pull in a quick effect. And then what we'll do here is we'll get rid of sounds that come with the clip. Pull this up right here, and it sounds better than it would if you were using the audio that comes with the original clip. And one other thing that is really great, that's going to up your audio quality a lot, is swooshes. Swooshes, simply put, are just sound effects that bump up the impact of the shot, make it sound more epic. So I'll go ahead and pull one in real quick here. You can get pretty much swoosh effects pretty easily on YouTube. Just gotta search for a little bit. So I'll pull one in here real quick. And again, I'm not editing this at all, so it's not gonna sound that great on the tutorial, but if you were to do this in an actual edit, it would look a lot better and sound a lot better. So obviously you can hear that it kind of builds up, and then you've got the impact shot here, and then it goes down. You can get the point of how this would be very effective in an actual edit, but obviously for this edit, it's not going to sound or look very good. That's about the majority of what I want to go over in this video. Again, it's just a very, very basic tutorial. I'll definitely make a second one. If you want to see more or something else you are confused on, you can definitely DM me on Twitter or Discord. I'll link those in the description. And also, I'm going to link a couple projects I've worked on in the description. They'll be super cheap, maybe $1 or $2, just so I can get those out to people who want to see them. I'll try to include clips and cinematics if I can so you can see how they look, but every project file will have all the effects that I use, how I've keyframed them, all the like layering that I do, so you can kind of take a look at all that and see how it works in a full finished edit. If you want me to get another one of these on something else, definitely let me know. Thanks for watching.